Hey guys, welcome back to the next video, and this time we're looking at something new from MSI. This is the Coreliquid A13 360mm AIO in white. Okay, so we have the new MAG Coreliquid A13 360 in white from MSI. Big thank you to MSI for sending this out for a review. Let's get this box undone, is it? Okay, let's take a look at it, shall we? Let's have a look. Oh, user manual right there with the QR code. Cool. It's quite a big box for a 360. Quite big, yep. Quite big. The foam, and then, oh, wow. Okay, there's a lot of stuff here. MSI shout out, I've actually used this in the past with buying MSI products. These are the mounting brackets, does come with thermal paste, comes with the AMD as well as the Intel brackets, so that's quite cool. And then, bit of foam. Let me get this out and we'll have a look. Okay, so here it is. Has a very nice copper base. I don't think I've actually seen a copper base bit like that before. That's quite cool. But yeah, it's got this in on top, which is really nice. I do like that. That's lovely as well. But then again, white products in general are just lovely. Does have fans. There's the radiator. Factory sealed. This will be a standard radiator size. And to be honest, it looks quite nice. So look at these connectors. So it does have ARGB. It's 4-pin. The pump. Please. Ah, pump 3-pin. MSI. So, let's have a look at this now. How does this come off? Okay, it looks like it just comes off like that. But, yeah. Right, so let's get through some of the specs, shall we? Okay, so when it comes to socket support, it does support LGA 1700 and 1851. And it does support AM4 and AM5. Now, the radiator dimensions are 394 by 119.6 with 27.2 millimeters. That's the radiator size. The radiator material obviously is aluminium. The water cooling tube length is 390 millimeters with 15.35 inches. The pump is rated for 25,000 hours in typical use. It has a 20 dB average with a 0.24 amp with a 2.88 watts, and the overall pump speed is 3800 rpm. So as for the fan dimensions, these are 120 by 25. That's the thickness. The fan speed is between 500 and 2000 rpm. The CFM is 62.6 CFM with a noise level of 31.1 dBA. The start pressure is 2.36 millimeter H2O. That's actually not bad. The fan bearings are rifle bearings, and the fans are actually rated for 40,000 hours at 40 degrees. Now the fan rated current is 0.15 amps, and the wattage is 1.8 watts, and it's ARGB Gen 2. As for that, now this looks gorgeous. I like white products in general. The cables, but here, yes, proprietary, but seems like everyone's going down in this route, and to be honest, it makes the product look a lot nicer once it's installed. So speaking of installed, let's get this on my test bench. Okay, so to install the brackets for AM5, you got to remove the Intel ones first, like that, so they come in pre-installed. And of course, then this is for Intel right here as well, so we'll get that down. Come on. Okay, so that's done. Now, as I've got a AM5 test bench, I'm going to be installing the AM5 bracket. So what you do is you go like this, it slides into this gap here which is already there, then you put the screws in. This can only go one way, just so everyone knows. It only goes in one direction, is that way. It doesn't, can't be put in the other slot. So then you screw it down, screw it down, and quite honestly, that's quite a good mechanism. And then by here, like that, And to be honest, it's quite easy, and it's quite simple, to be honest. You don't even need to read the manual, quite honestly. Once you remove the Intel brackets, there's only one other bracketry in here, which will be for AMD's CPUs, so, and motherboard. So it's quite easy to understand once you actually know. But this is just me showing how to install the brackets. Very easy. Don't need to tighten them really, so just wait until they bottom out, and that's pretty much it. And then all you do is install it. So let's get this in the test bench. Remember, with AM5, you do use the backplate that's already on the motherboard. With AM4, you would probably have to hold the backplate at the back just to install it. Okay, so for the installation part, now I have shown you how to put these on. Very easy process. What you do now is put your thermal paste on. Put the thermal paste in the middle. This is specifically for AM5, but this will work with AM4, but you'll have to hold the back plate while doing it. So, paste is there. Now, what you want to do is grab it, okay? Grab it, like that. You lay it down. Lay it down, like that. Now, the best way to do this will be a four-point system, so you do, or a crisscross pattern, you do it one side there, like that. Do it that side. It's just so it catches, so you don't have to continuously move it. So don't worry if it just moves, it's going to. And you continue this until it bottoms out completely. So you start with the one you just did. Then you go back to this one. And then back to this one. What this will initially do is actually spread the thermal paste proper. Now, obviously, it'll just spread it evenly. That's what this is for. It's for even tension on each side. So there's that one. Yep, there's that one. That one's done. That one's done. That one's all done, and there we go, and that's it, pretty much installed. Okay, so this is the MSI Coreliquid A13 360 AIO. Now, this isn't a proper noise test, but this is just to give you a general idea of how it sounds at 50% and 100% fan speed. So this is 50%. So as you can hear, there's literally no noise. So same thing, but 100% fan speed. Now, of course, with the side panel on, it will dampen the noise, but at 100% fan speed, they are noticeable. So, okay, so when it comes to the overall system specifications that I used for the overall test, then, well, it is on AM5, it's an AMD Ryzen 9 7900, it does have 16 gigs of DDR5, it is on a B650 motherboard with an RX 7800 XT Nitro Plus, and also it's got a 1000 watt power supply from Kolink, as well as it's housed in the B-Quiet Shadow Base 800 FX case. Okay, so when it comes to the overall benchmarking, now what I'm going to say is I do my initial two runs as I normally do, the 50% fan speed and 100% fan speed. Now, For the room temperature, when I did the testing, it was early in the morning, so the temperature was only at 10 degrees, but it did rise up by 4, so it did go up to 14 Celsius after testing. Now, this will be for 50% fan speed. I'm running the exact same benchmarks that I always run. And as for CPU power, for 50% fan speed, the highs the CPU went was 167 watts, but the lows went down to 145. The CPU clocks were at high of 5.5, but did go down to 5.1, but it's well above base clock, and that's fine. So as for Cinebench R23, the idles were 33 Celsius, the max was 83. Blender Pavilion, idles 33 with a max of 82. Blender Classroom, idles 33 with a max of 82. And 3D Mark Super Test, idles 33 with a max of 63 Celsius. Okay, so when it comes for the 100% fan speed, that does also include the case fans. Now, the CPU power, this did actually start drawing more power. It started high at 170 watts, but did go down to 161 watts. So it didn't lose as much power. The CPU clocks were 5.5 and the lows were 5.1. Exactly the same, but it was well above base clock. You don't have to worry there. So as for the Cinebench R23 run, the idles are 29 Celsius with a max of 82. Blender Pavilion, idles 29 with a max of 79. Blender Classroom, idles 29 with a max of 80. And 3D Mark CPU Test, idles 29 with a max of 63 Celsius. Okay then, so yes, I did go through the installation process. I haven't done that in any of my previous videos before, but that's because I am trying to improve the content as much as possible. Doesn't matter if you guys don't notice, but just believe that every video I do improve on something. Now, this, for the price range, is around £80. It's actually a good AIO. Now, no, it's not the best AIO, but considering the price range that MSI are trying to beat, then, quite honestly, it's a very tough competition, especially at this price point, especially with Thermalright, Deepcool. There's loads of different brands at this price point that they're trying to beat. But what I will say, this does look amazing once it's actually installed and lit up with the RGB. But then considering that, there's a lot of competition out there, like I just said. So whether you buy it or not, that's up to you. I'm not here to tell you to buy it or not, but still. But if you're going to buy it, then use this link that pops up right here, which is backtotheoffice.co.uk, and use this code, which is right there, WELSHYTECH5. If you use that code, you do get 5% off once you do the checkout. But remember that that is only on orders over £50. So save money, and this will be the cheapest in the UK currently. Fantastic. You save money, you get a product that looks amazing, and quite honestly, I like MSI products, but that's just me personally. So yeah, now I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please make sure to check out the hundreds of videos I've got so much different content. You guys might actually like some of the builds I've done. They're quite spectacular, and I do have some more builds coming in the future. And as for stuff coming, make sure you subscribe, because Sapphire has said that once they get a spare sample of an RX 9070 XT Nitro, they will be sending me one over to look at. So that will be a head-to-head with my Nitro Plus, and also I will do a review of that as well. So remember, backtotheoffice.co.uk, save 5% at checkout, for orders over £50. And as always, I hope you guys have a fantastic weekend and week ahead of you. This is Richard for WELSHYTECH. Goodbye.